First, they freeze your accounts. Now they say, you ain't getting your money back. But wait, wait a second. I have some breaking news. We have some solutions to all this. Yes, go ahead, Skylar, in the control room. What is the solution that they have for us? Oh, you're putting it up on the screen now? I don't know. I don't think that's a solution. Actually, that is called the plan. Cue the fire. You will absolutely, unequivocally own nothing and you will be happy. But in this video, we're going to look at where we move in our money today. We have crypto. Where are we moving it? We're talking Bitcoin tops and bottoms. So if you want to know the top, I told you where the top was, but I think you're going to be interested in the bottom. And the Fed be pivoting a little bit. And that was a terrible pivot. How about that for, ooh, Fed got some moves, but I'm going to show you based on indicators that we might be at the top. So the bond market might become interesting to you. But like always, really, I help you. Thanks for subscribing. I help you on this channel, okay? Because I know you're like, but I can't even pay rent. Everything's so expensive. That is because every, let's say 4 months on any given asset, we're like, okay, we got to move it, move it. We got to move it, move it. Move it every day. We got to move that money so we could pay for our rent. Gosh, I wish it was so easy that we could just, I don't know, save, right? Can we just save for a rainy day? Oh, okay, it's 20% we're going to lose if we just save. That's great. Okay, where do we need to go? Preserving wealth. Manhattan rents reach record. Can you guys believe this? This is just regular, you know, $5,000 a month on average in June. If you would like to live in that lovely city of a sardine can, which is fine because you can do you. I just need to breathe a little bit. My wife will take me shopping there, but oh, that's a tough one. Good food though, right? Okay. All right. I get it. Oh, and also I think this story is maybe a lie. 5,000 per month. The Fed only raised rent or the inflation CPI only 5% this year. So I don't know how you're getting 5,000. Also, so for those of you that are paying rent, and you might be late, you're like, okay, you know, instead of the dog ate my homework, my bank, I can't get it out. Currently banking with Celsius, analyst clients, and then they'll go like, oh, I actually believe you. Yep, we're not getting our money. Well, I guess you're not getting money. Clients of crypto lender Celsius face long waits. Yeah, you could be waiting a very long time over fate of their funds. Let's talk about what happens in bankruptcy. That would be called you're not getting your money back. There is a lot of banks going poof, bye, right? When they say, when the water recedes, who is left wearing pants? Not me. I'm into skinny dipping, so I'm coming out clean. I go in naked, I come out naked. It's just like the womb. Actually, I probably came out with board shorts on and this hair, just to let you know. Baby pictures, I was like, Johnny Bravo. Bitcoin, here is another problem. Bitcoin miner woes. Oh, wah, wah, wah. Risk getting more worser after Celsius collapse. Why is this? And I know this because I used to do this. Lender owns over 80,000 mining rigs. Ooh. And I actually built mine way back in the day, showing my high school students how to mine money out of thin air. They're like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. I had all these rigs going, computer screens, making all this money. That's it. Well, I mean, the electric bill. Fortunately, I had solar. Electric bill was a little high. But then to see all that money build up, and then what do you do with that? You actually can buy things with that said Bitcoin. It does have some downside though. One, your house will heat up to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's loud AF. And there came a time where my wife said, it's either me or the rigs. And I said, can I have some time to think about this one? And I actually remember talking to my class about the lovely Bitcoin when it was at a dollar. I'm like, how could something that doesn't even exist be worth more than the US dollar? That was like mind-blowing. And you're like, you're calling that money? Wow, that's wild. But then I started getting in a little later, probably right here, before we had this one. But in this video, I shall show you volume. which you don't care. Sorry, I had to reset my charts for this one. You have a thing called TOPS, Pi Cycle TOPS. Now, this indicator has been adjusted slightly. I think the guys in the back end kind of tinkered with it, but it's basically moving averages. It gets pretty close. I'm like, okay, I'll have to hand it to you until it's wrong. But looking at, we have a top, we have a bottom, we have a top, okay. Hey, it did not get to the top correctly. And then as you can see, these moving averages, which actually I have to use two completely separate indicators to show you, tops and bottoms. Guess what it's calling on? It's like, hey, I think we got a possible bottom here. And I would say, well, the charts, I know that you say that, but that is called a bear flag. Guess what this one's called? Oh, that would be another bear flag. So I'm not going to go, ha, 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 you're buying Bitcoin at 19 or 18,000. Congratulations. At least you weren't up there with Skyler at 70K. And also, there is a lot of confusion between this CBDC, which I've been talking about for probably 4 years. That's the government, that is not blockchain, that is not Bitcoin, it is complete control over when you spend it, how you spend it, and I believe the people will go, please, government, help us, and they're going to give it to you. They're going to take the Fed's balance sheet, they're going to monetize it, or however they want to do it, create another entry on their balance sheet, like Chuck E. Cheese tokens. Oh, we're going to create a reserve. Like, that's all they have to do. It's pretty easy. They could probably get around Congress on this one, but we will see. This one does not solve the problem. This one will be great at the beginning, but then basically destroy you in the end. Now, the question is, central bank digital currencies are coming. What will be the consequences? Well, death. But they will tout it as the greatest, you know, we'll control inflation, we'll control deflation, because they could say, okay, you need to spend it between this time and this time. Oh, you can't spend it on alcohol. Oh, you can't spend it here because, you know, greenhouse effect, or you can't do this, or you can't do that. And the woke will celebrate. Yay! This is amazing, as the noose gets tighter and tighter around the neck. But people don't see that. It's like the path to hell is paved with great intentions. Well, until you get to hell. And at that point, I hope you have your sunscreen. ECB, I've been also hearing about this. So we hit Bitcoin. If you want to buy now. Oh, also, since today is Woody Wagon Day, and hey, who couldn't use a nice Woody? 75% off. If I have two courses, if you want, if you're like, I love crypto, do the crypto one. But you should probably start with swing trading. If you're like, what are these lines? What software are you using? If you're asking those kind of questions, start with the swing trade. Like an example would be here. This is on the dollar. You could trade it UUP. Never financial advice. You turn on my little indicators, which I have to adjust. It comes with little buy, sell. Right now, another beat down on the dollar so we can jump back in. Just in case you wanted to know when you entered, right there. That was it. That was your 200-day moving average. And it has just rode that doggy all the way up to $28.86. And for those of you that got in on the last swing, right, you're still holding. You swing. For the rest of you that are new, you're like, patience. You have to wait. Wait for said beatdown. Wait for reversal. I don't know. Sometimes it might not ever come. It's like when Bitcoin's rocket ship, I'm like, shoot. You going to reverse at any point? Well, here's your reversal. And then ECB, we're going to have another reversal from the Fed. Oh my gosh. So where's the play on that one? That would be the bond market, probably about a month ago. So hopefully you were listening. ECB bond tool seen having no limits as steeper rates, rate hike looms. And to kind of help you understand this article here, the European Central Bank, that's the ECB, will unveil. Oh, hold on. Let me unveil what do we got here? An unlimited bond buying tool next week to help markets better adjust. Go ahead. Go buy my bonds all day long. And when I made this play a few months ago, time goes by fast. You're like, you're crazy. Everything's going to zero. Bonds, right? And now it's like, oh, hey. Hey, look, see, contrarian. I honestly, when I was calling bonds, I was the 5%. I mean, I have articles that are like 95% of everyone says, which it is garbage. I get it. It's dead. It's evil. It's horrible. But we just have to keep moving. Wall Street most accurate analyst. The Fed will pivot in November. And I'm telling you, the futures, I've been saying that for months. You try to buy it in the future. You're like, wow, huh, this is weird. If you were to get into a time machine, you will find bond prices moving that way and yields moving that way. And how do I know this? Well, that's because of charts. I teach you how to do charts. And if you don't, that's why I have a course. I'm like, here, just do the course. So you're not, you want to be intelligent. Look, all right, so here you go. Here's your yield. See, we have hiking cycle ends. See, above my head that my finger cannot get into. Hiking cycle ends. All right. Do you see a possible pattern? I'm telling you, everything is in the charts. What is happening right now? Well, we're hitting the top. That's why I'm like, okay. Now, if I have to wait to get out of this thing in a year from now, so I don't have to pay capital gains tax, okay. You know, at least I'm close. I mean, just with the Fed threatening to increase their overnight lending rate, housing market pops. I mean, bond market, the minute the Fed was like, okay, the bond took off. Well, what took down? You had what's happened? The housing market has popped. The global economy is on fire. We now have food lines again. But I guess we're not in a recession yet. Don't hold your breath, Skylar. And not just that, we have an inversion of the yield curve that is seen like no other. When on a 1 year, look at the 1 year, 3.1, was it 3.2? The 30-year yield up there, 3.0, makes no sense. And we knew this was coming when euro dollars inverted. Was it last year? Probably 6 months ago. Was it November? Yeah, when that happened, that was an easy call. I was like, recession. And how many times has it predicted it? Every single one of them. For those of you that don't understand return on investment on a 1 year, which this is the 1 year that's showing on the chart. Okay, yeah, you should get maybe, let's say, 0.5%. But if I were to loan you my money for 30 years, okay, you can have 5%. Well, it's switched. So what that's telling you is that in the future, it's gonna get really bad. And I know the government's telling you everything's great, right? But I know you. And I know what it looks like outside. And it's not what the government tells you. Huh, could this be that word that starts with prop and then ends with someone's ganda? Yes. Despite U.S. unemployment approaching a multi-decade low, everyone has 12 jobs, right? Food banks across the country are working overtime. Yep. Like never seen before, everyone's starving to death. But wait, you have seen nothing yet. For some reason, they're blowing up everything that has to do with food. Huh. Maybe, I wonder if Bill, that dude that puts gates around his house has a solution for that. And like always, I try to provide solutions on this channel. And I could be right, I could be wrong, but at least I'm trying. Again, my only solutions, do this. That's not go shopping, but produce things, right? I don't care if it's plastic things, I don't care if it's a side hustle, you have to start businesses. If you can do it passively, do that. And then learn how to move your money every few months. You just got to move it because you're not going to survive. In high school, we'd do a budget and the kids would just blow their heads up when they were like, I have to make how much an hour? Well, I'll show you. Here we go. Inflation, impossible choice, middle class Americans. Oh, by the way, middle class Americans are wiped out and going to be wiped out. It is part of their beautiful solution. But right now, you need to make about $28 an hour to survive. But the truth is, that's $20 an hour that you need to make to survive. And then you have to have about three other roommates. This is actually a question that I ask people all the time. Like, I'm wondering, in the comments section, how much to survive basically with nothing? Well, you have a car, you know, you got your job, you get to go out to eat once in a while, things like that. You're not like extravagant. Maybe you can go to Vegas once a year, something. How much do you need to make a year? Most people are saying between 60,000, 80,000, somewhere between 60 and 80. I am curious, just two numbers, like 60, 80 or 90 or 100, 110. I guess it depends on where you live, too. New York, you're probably looking at 90. I don't know. Out here in Texas, people keep saying 60 to 80. Just curious what you guys have to say, but it is the weekend. Oh, my goodness gracious. The crowd goes wild. Enjoy your weekend, and I will see you tomorrow because I work every single day of my life.